if we're really going to make the most of the opportunities that are ahead of us, we need to all embrace the fact that audiences now have a range of sources, and that's a fantastic thing for organisations like ours. We know that people are getting their information from a range of sources, they're engaging with it, they're comparing it, and when they like it, and sometimes when they don't like it, they share it. And for the ABC, that now means that we're tapping into new audiences, people that we might not have known that they had access to before. I think that greater choice in relation to information certainly poses some challenges for us. And to a certain extent, there are parts of the audience that certainly are attracted to sites and to information that reinforces their own mindset. But there's also a huge space out there for those who want to exchange ideas and have a diversity of opinion, and that's certainly where the ABC is. The free flow of information, I think, has been empowering for the audience and for media organisations, but I also think it's highlighted the benefits of a formal news structure in supporting quality journalism, legal, ethical and editorial frameworks, and very, very clear standards. I think the role of journalism, I agree with people, remains the same, is to inform, to engage, to stimulate discussion and debate on issues of national significance and social significance. And, I know it's the buzzword, but really to curate a range of ideas and opinions. And I think that the way we practice journalism and the value of journalism has and is changing. For the ABC, that certainly means a change in the relationship with the audience. I think at the previous session, we talked about the fact that we had a very one-way conversation with our audiences in the past, whereby we delivered news and audiences consumed our news. Now we see the opportunities in making sure that it's not a one-way conversation, or you're